Well, if you're sure it's all right.
I cut, thank you, that's fine.
Elstree, Britain's first studio, established in 1926, and ever since the foremost, the first in Britain to produce films with sound, and which rose to prominence with the help of a young director, Alfred Hitchcock. 2 years ago, it was sold by Thorne EMI to an Australian company, and then the giant Canon Group. Despite some hard times, since 1975, it's made a series of blockbusters, including all the Star Wars films, and with director Stephen Speilberg at the helm, the Indiana Jones series. The latest, Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade, is currently under production there. Spielberg and the crew have been devastated by the news.
I was under the impression, I had been told, that the Canon people, Globus and Golden, had promised never to sell the studio for real estate and land development. And I took them to their word and felt very secure that I would have a very, very long and secure run here in the UK making movies at this studio. So it comes as a great personal disappointment, and I'm a bit ashamed of the Canon people for selling out to a big business profit and all the commercial concerns.
So what's it going to do to you, because you've, as you say, lost your home here now in England to film?
Well, I don't know. I really frankly don't know what I'm going to do now. I don't know whether we just look around Europe for another location for our European office and our home front. We'll be investigating other possibilities to make our movies.
We could lose you.
Well, I mean, there's certainly, you know, still, you know, Pinewood and Shepparton, but this is really our home, and I feel in a way that Simon Legrees have come into our lives and foreclosed on the mortgage, and now we're a bit, we all feel, I think, a bit like the orphans of the storm.
Roger, what's this, a tweeting bird?
The last Elstree production, Who Framed Roger Rabbit, is a runaway box office hit in America. The filmmakers are baffled by Canon's claims that the studios are not a viable concern. They say successful films since Star Wars in 1975 have ensured steady profits. Now, they say, the British film industry has been dealt a body blow it may not fully recover from.
I think that, you know, ultimately this will open the way for people taking movies into particularly the Eastern Bloc countries, who are now courting Western films, who have stage space facilities. This will be a big loss to this country and to our industry per se. I think that what's happened here is that part of our heritage has been taken away, and certainly a big chunk of our future, because a third of the stage space available in large studios will no longer exist. Therefore, there are 10 stages which can never be used again. And therefore, somewhere down the line, there are going to be a number of films that will not be able to shoot in this country as a result.
We have let it be known within the industry, especially in Hollywood, that we were not happy with the studios, that we were running at a loss. And in fact, I am pretty certain that Menachem Golan, my chairman, had a conversation with Mr. Spielberg or one of his associates. And Mr. Spielberg was actually aware of the fact that we would sell the studio if someone else wanted to take it as a going concern. But nobody else has come along.
Filming will stop in October and 70 jobs will go. A property company are taking over the site, but it's not clear what they'll do with it.
The fear is that this, the heart of the British film industry, could become a housing estate or even a supermarket, and that unlike a film script, it's unlikely to have a happy ending. Unless, that is, a superhero like Indiana Jones can come to the rescue. Mark Longhurst at Elstree for Thames News.